Hello students, I am Satit Rakas. Welcome to Cars Physics. We are continuing chapter number 2, Electric Potential and Capacitance, and this is my lecture number 22 on the chapter. In this lecture, we will discuss some fundamental numericals on combination of capacitors. Okay. So we have already discussed the expression for equivalent capacitance in series grouping of capacitors and equivalent capacitance in parallel grouping of capacitors if series and parallel again meet. Okay, in a circuit where there will be series grouping and parallel grouping, series combination and parallel combination, then we will say it mixed grouping of capacitors. Okay, the expressions we have already found, and in this lecture, see the numericals on combination of capacitors I have divided into some different parts, and this is part 1 of the discussion. So in this lecture we will discuss some fundamental or basic numericals, means directly speaking very easier numericals. We will discuss very easier numericals, or you may say fundamental numericals, in this lecture. This is part 1, the discussion on numericals based on combination of capacitors. Then we will move to part 2. In part 2, we will learn some application range questions, and also I will show you some very good numericals which may be useful for your competitive, means for NEET and JEE, etc. But this lecture is based on 2 fundamental numericals. Okay. So as we know, a number of capacitors are said to be connected in series. A number of capacitors are said to be connected in series if second plate of first capacitor is connected to first plate of second capacitor, and so on. Okay, second plate of first capacitor is connected to first plate of second capacitor, and so on, means second plate of second capacitor is connected to first plate of third capacitor, and so on. Let's consider the n capacitors are connected in series, first plate of first capacitor and second plate of last capacitor are connected to the terminals of a cell or battery. If this is our cell, if this is our cell, then potential of this terminal is 0, this terminal is at potential V, then total potential difference is V, then we may say potential in this circuit is V, then total charge is Q. Okay, this is positive, this is negative, this is positive, negative, positive, negative, so total charge is Q, total charge is Q, total charge is Q. Potential differences are V1, V2. Let's consider this is C3. This is C. Okay. Let's consider 3 capacitors are connected in series. Then what is our output? First theoretical concept. Second plate of first capacitor is connected to first plate of second capacitor. Second plate of second capacitor is connected to first plate of third capacitor. Okay. This is the rule of combination. Then in series, total charge in the circuit is Q, then this is also charge on the capacitors. Thus in series grouping, charge remains same on all the capacitors, but potential difference may be different. As we know, C is equal to Q by V, and this implies V is equal to Q by C. So ratio of potential differences are V1 is to V2 is to V3. Since Q is same, that's 1 by C1 1 by C2 1 by C3. So ratio potential differences across the capacitors is equal to ratio of reciprocal of capacitances in series. So this is about series grouping of capacitors. Let's draw an example of numerical. Okay. Question number one, let 2 capacitors
let two capacitors C1 and C2, let two capacitors C1 and C2, let C1 is 3 microfarad, C1 is 3 microfarad and C2 is 6 microfarad are connected in series, are connected in series. 3 microfarad and 6 microfarad, two capacitors of capacitance C1, C2, 3 and 6 microfarad are connected in series between the terminals of a cell. Total potential difference is V. Okay. It is given, potential difference between the plates of first capacitor, potential difference between the plates of first capacitor is V1, let it be 20 volt. It is given. C1, C2 given. Potential difference between the plates of first capacitor is V1. V1 is 20 volt. Then it is asked, find total potential difference of the supply battery or the cell. Okay. Also, it may be asked to find total charge, or it may be asked to find equivalent capacitance in series. Okay. So all these, if you find V, then all these will come. Okay. Then C1 and C2 are in series, then equivalent capacitance in series 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. Reciprocal of series group capacitance is sum of reciprocal of capacitances. So series group capacitance is C1 plus C2, 1 by Cs, C1, C2. Then formula for series group capacitance is C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. If two capacitors of capacitances C1 and C2 connected in series, then the final result of equivalent capacitance in series is C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2. C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2 is series group capacitance of two capacitors connected in series. Okay, I am erase it now. So it is given V1 is equal to 20 volt, we have to calculate V, total charge, equivalent capacitance and so many things. Okay. Then C is equal to Q by V, V is equal to Q by C. As we know, if total charge is Q, then charge on each capacitor in series is also Q. Charge remains same in series. Then V is equal to Q by C. Here potential difference is V1. Then V1 is equal to Q by C1. V1 is equal to Q by C1. Is it correct? Okay. Then V1 is given. V1 is 20 volt Q. C1 is 3 microfarad. Then this implies total charge is equal to 3 microfarad into 20 volt. So total charge is 60 micro coulomb. Okay. Total charge is 60 micro coulomb. We have got total charge. Let's write here the answer, 60 micro coulomb. Okay. We have got total charge. Then we have to find total capacitance. Total capacitance we may find C1 is 3 microfarad, C2 is 6 microfarad divided by 3 plus 6. So series group capacitance is 18 divided by 9, that equals to 2 microfarad. Okay, total capacitance. Then final answer, we have to calculate total potential difference. Okay. Then here charge is same. This is the charge. Capacitance is C2. Then what is V2? V2 is equal to Q by C2. V2 is equal to Q by C2. V is equal to Q by C. V2 is equal to Q. Total charge on this capacitor is Q. Capacitance is C2. Then V2 is equal to charge 60 microcoulomb. C2 is 6 microfarad. Micro get cancelled. Then V2 is equal to 10 volt. V2 is equal to 10 volt. Then total potential difference V is equal to V1 plus V2. Potential or potential difference are scalars. So algebraic sum of V1 and V2. So V is equal to V1 is given 20. V2 V2 is the same, then total voltage is 30 volt.
Total voltage is 30 volt. Okay, is it easier? Too easier, not easier, too easier. Purely fundamental based question.
Then question number 2. About parallel grouping of capacitors, combination of capacitors in parallel,
then don't forget the fundamental definition. A number of capacitors are said to be connected in parallel. A number of capacitors are said to be connected in parallel if first plates of all capacitors are connected to a common point and second plates of all capacitors are connected to another common point, and finally the common points are connected to the terminals of a cell or battery. Okay, so in parallel, in series charge remains same, in parallel potential difference remains same. In series, total charge in the circuit is equal to charge on each capacitor. In parallel, total potential of the circuit is equal to potential across all the capacitors, or potential difference between the plates, two plates of each capacitor is equal to total potential difference of the circuit. In series, potential difference may be different. In parallel, charges are different. In series, there is no division of charge. In parallel, charge gets divided among the capacitors in parallel. In series, charge is not get divided. In parallel, charge gets divided into different branches. Okay? Suppose, question number 2, three capacitors,
C1. Let's say capacitance is C1, C2. Of capacitances, C1 is equal to 1 microfarad, C2 is equal to 2 microfarad, and C3 is equal to 3 microfarad are connected in parallel. Okay. Three capacitors are connected in parallel. Okay. If potential difference between terminals of the cell is 10 volt, let total potential difference is 10 volt, find charge on each capacitor. And charge on each capacitor, see, I will show you two representations of parallel grouping of capacitors. Okay? I will show you two types of representations. Let's see. The first type you know, suppose this is one capacitor. This is one capacitor. And this is one capacitor, C1, C2, C3, okay. These are two common points, A and B, okay. First plates of all capacitors are connected to a common point, second plates are connected to another common point, and finally, the common points are connected between the terminals of cell. And of course, this is our cell. Potential of B is 0, potential of A is B, so this is B. This is 0, so potential difference is V. Total charge is Q. Then charge on capacitor C1 is Q1, here Q2, here Q3. Okay. This is the concept. Okay. This representation may be given as C. If this potential is V, then this potential is V, then this potential is 0, because this plate is connected to point A. Potential of point A is equal to potential of this plate. Similarly, potential of this plate is V. This is 0, V, 0. So potential difference between the plates of all capacitors in parallel is V, and that's equals to total potential difference. This is the concept. So this representation may be given as 1, 2, 3. This is C1, this is C2, this is C3. Then obviously we will say these three are in series. Okay. Then now let's take like this. This is a conducting wire. C1, C2. This is a conducting wire, okay. Let this point is A, this point is A, this point is C, and this point is B. A conducting wire is connected joining two points A and C, and another conducting wire is connected joining the two points. This point is B, let this point is D, D and B, this point is B. So this representation is equivalent to this representation, same, nothing is a difference. Okay, see, potential of point A is V, so here also potential is V, because potential difference, sorry, potential decreases if work is done. Work done is equal to potential difference into charge. Okay, so potential decreases if work is done between A point and this plate. Between point A and this plate, there is no obstruction. If we consider the resistance of the wires is zero, resistance, the concept will be discussed in current electricity, then there is no obstruction, there is no opposition, so potential of point A is equal to potential of this plate. D. See, if point A and point C are joined by a conducting wire, so potential of A is V, so potential of C is V, because there is no obstruction. So this plate is connected to point C, so potential of this plate is V, because there is no obstruction in this path. Again, this plate is connected to C, so this plate also is at potential V. Potential of A is V, so potential of this plate is V. Potential of C is V, so potential of this plate is V, and potential of this plate is V. So between these two points A and B, there is a capacitor. So work will be done in transferring the charge, in charging the capacitor. Let potential of this point is V1, potential of this point is V1, means B is connected to B. Potential of B is V1, but we have taken potential of B is 0, so potential of B is 0. So potential of this plate is 0, because this plate is connected to D. Potential of this plate is also 0, because this plate is connected to D. So accordingly, this plate is connected to point B, potential of B is 0, so potential is 0. See, all these three plates, 1, 2, 3, all these three plates are at same potential V, V, V. So these are the respective plates. Okay. So all these three plates are at zero potential. These are three plates at zero potential. Okay. So these three capacitors C1, C2, C3 are also in parallel. This is the concept. This is called as potential method. I am not applying potential method in this lecture. In part 2, we will discuss some numericals based on potential method. So there are some numericals which can't be solved. There are some numericals which can't be solved using division of charge method in parallel grouping. Okay. So we can't recognize the circuit. In that case, potential method is highly important to recognize the circuit for distribution of charge
to find the equivalent capacitance. So just wait. We are starting from very thermal or very easier numericals.
Okay. So this is the given numerical. Okay. I'm representing again for clarity of yours. Understand? This is capacitance C1. This is capacitance C2. This is capacitance C3. Okay. All these three capacitors are connected in parallel. Okay. This point is A, this point is B. Okay. Potential difference between the terminals means potential difference between A and B is 10 volt. C1 is 1 microfarad, C2 is 2 microfarad, C3 is 3 microfarad, as it is mentioned in the question. So we have to find charge on each capacitor if total charge is Q. If you connect this between positive and negative, this is positive negative, total potential difference is 10 volt. This is B. B is, let's take B. This is B. B is 10 volt, then total charge is Q. Charge on this capacitor is Q1, on this is Q2, on this is Q3. On this is Q3. Okay. Charge on capacitance C3 is Q3. And total voltage between A and B is 10 volt. Okay. Then let's first find total capacitance in parallel or equivalent capacitance in parallel. Let's draw another circuit. We have combined three capacitors. This is equivalent capacitance in parallel, and equivalent capacitance in parallel is C1 plus C2 plus C3, 1 plus 2 plus 3, that equals to 6 microfarad. 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 3, 6, 6 microfarad is equivalent capacitance in parallel. Okay. Then total charge in the circuit is Q, total voltage is V. Then Q is equal to C, capacitance is Q by V, Q is equal to CV, then total charge is total capacitance in parallel, product of total capacitance and total voltage, then total charge is 6. Microfarad, V is 10 volt, means 60 micro coulomb. Total charge is 60 micro coulomb. Is it clear? So it is not asked to find total charge. We have just found it. Okay. We have calculated total capacitance and total charge. Total charge is 60 micro coulomb. Okay. Then it is asked to calculate capacitance on each capacitor. If total voltage is V, then potential difference between the plates of all capacitors is V. Then, as you know, Q is equal to CV, then Q1 is equal to C1 into V. Potential difference V, charge is Q1, capacitance is C1. Then C1 is 1, potential difference is 10, then Q1 is equal to 10 microcoulomb. Because capacitance in microfarad, so charge is microcoulomb. So similarly, Q2 is C2V, C2 is 2 microfarad into potential difference 10 means 20 microcoulomb. Similarly, Q3 is C3V, C3 is 3 microfarad, potential difference 10 means 30 microcoulomb. So the answers are 10 microcoulomb, 20 microcoulomb, and 30 microcoulomb. Is it clear? These are two easier and purely board-based questions, but in physics nothing can be ignored. Nothing can be ignored in physics. Everything is important. Okay. Then, next question. I think it is question number 3. Okay, from the basics of series and parallel grouping of capacitors, this is very easy question, just you have to use the formula and purely board-based question, question number 3. Two capacitors, I am not writing the questions completely, two capacitors are first connected in series, in series and in power. Okay. Then series group capacitance, equivalent capacitance in series, equivalent capacitance in series given 4 by 3 microfarad, and equivalent capacitance in parallel is given 6 microfarad. Then it is asked to find capacitance, find capacitance of each capacitor. This is very easy question. Find capacitance of each capacitor. Two capacitors are connected in series, series group capacitance or equivalent capacitance in series is 4 by 3 microfarad. Similarly, equivalent capacitance in parallel is 6 microfarad. Then find total capacity, sorry, find the capacitances of each capacitor. So capacitance in series, 1 by series group capacitor, there are two capacitors, 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2, and that equals to C1 plus C2 divided by C1, C2. Then series group capacitance is C1, C2 and C1 plus C2. Then series group capacitance is 4 by 3 is equal to microfarad. We will take it later. C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Okay. Then in parallel, capacitance is 6 microfarad. If two capacitors, so capacitance C1 and C2 are connected in parallel, then parallel group capacitance is C1 plus C2, as we know. Then parallel group capacitance is 6 microfarad is equal to C1 plus C2. Then use this value in this equation. Okay. Then 4 by 3 is equal to C1 C2 divided by C1 plus C2. In place of C1 and C2 I can write 6. So C1 C2 is equal to 4 divided by 3 into 6. So C1 into C2 is, this is 2, this is 4, 4 into 2 is 8. Okay. Then we have got C1 plus C2. Then to solve there are many ways, also very shortcut ways, but do first like this. C1 minus C2 whole square is equal to C1 plus C2 whole square minus 4 C1 C2. This is basic formula. A minus B whole square is equal to A plus B whole square minus 4AB. Okay. So C1 minus C2 whole square is equal to C1 plus C2 whole square. C1 plus C2 is 6. 6 square is 36 minus 4. C1 into C2, C1 into C2 is 8, so 4 into 8, so C1 minus C2 whole square is equal to 36 minus 32, 4, means C1 minus C2 is 2. See, we have got C1 plus C2 is equal to 6, C1 minus C2 is equal to 4, then add it, 2 C1 is equal to 8, then this implies C1 is equal to 4 microfarad, and accordingly C2. If C1 is 4 microfarad, then C2 is 2 microfarad. 6 minus 4 is 2 microfarad. I think it is very easier for you. This is very fundamental question. The answers are 4 microfarad and 2 microfarad. Is it easier? Okay. Next. Let's move to next portion. We will raise the level gradually. We will raise the level gradually, not at once. Okay. Of course, capacitor releases energy at once. But we will attempt problem gradually. We will gradually raise the level of numericals. Okay. The next question, question number 4. Suppose a circuit is given like this. Of course, you may do. You may represent this circuit, equivalent circuit, okay, in first step, this is the given circuit, this part is A, this is a capacitor, let this capacitor is C2, capacitance is C2, 4 microfarad, and this is another capacitance, let capacitance is C1, C1 is equal to 2 microfarad, okay, and this is a capacitance, let C3, C3 is 3 microfarad and finally connected to B. So if it is asked to calculate effective capacitance or equivalent capacitance between A and B, you may consider A is connected to higher potential and B is at lower potential or potential of B, you may take 0. Okay. These are connected to the terminals of a cell. Then potential difference between A and B, A and B, V. Let it is given potential difference. This is at high potential, this is at low potential, it is given 12 volt. Okay. This is a circuit. As shown in figure, potential difference between A and B is 12 volt. Then what we have to do? Find, number one, equivalent capacitance of the combination, number one. Then find, number two, charges on the capacitors. Charges on the capacitors. Okay. We'll find equivalent capacitance and we'll find charge on each capacitor. I am writing here the data as total potential difference is 12 volt. Okay. And we'll first find equivalent capacitance and then charges on each capacitor. Okay. Let's observe the circuit. A is at a high potential. Okay. These are two capacitors. See, this is first plate, this is second plate. Okay. Sorry, this is first plate of capacitor C1, this is first plate of capacitor C2. Number of capacitors are said to be connected in parallel. If first plates of all capacitors are connected to a common point and second plates are connected to another common point and in parallel charge is divided. See, if total charge is Q, this plate, this is first plate connected to a common point, then charge gets divided, Q1 and Q2, okay. This is second plate, second plates are connected to another common point, then here, again total charge is Q. Q1, Q2, again total charge is Q, okay. So this is first plate, this is second. So this configuration may be represented as, take from it, these two obviously, in parallel, because charge is divided, we will discuss in later stage, division of potential means potential method. These two are in parallel, this is C1, this is C2, okay. And this is the connection connected to first plate of third capacitor, this is first plate of third capacitor, okay. And this is second plate, and this point is B, this is C3, okay. So, total voltage is given 12 volt, we have to find charge on each capacitor. See, total voltage is V. Okay, this is 0, this is at V, so total potential difference is 0. Sorry, V. V minus 0 is V. Okay. Then, it's equivalent circuit. C1 and C2 are in parallel. C1 and C2 are in parallel. Then total capacitance C1 plus C2, 2 plus 4 is 6 microfarad. We have already discussed these two are in parallel, 2 plus 4, 6. Then this is C3, C3 is 3 microfarad. Then connected to the two points A and B, total potential difference is V, means V is equal to 12 volt. Okay. Now, equivalent capacitance, see. Sum of these two capacitors is 6, 2 plus 4, 6, and this is 3. Now, these two are in series, then equivalent capacitance is C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2. C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2, 18 divided by 9 is 2 microfarad, is equivalent capacitance, you may represent here also. This is equivalent capacitance and this is the terminals. So this is equivalent capacitance, this is voltage V and total charge is Q. First circuit, second circuit, third circuit. This is final circuit. Then total charge, Q is equal to equivalent capacitance of the combination into potential difference V, Q V. Charge is equal to, sorry, Q is equal to CV, then equivalent capacitance is 2, potential difference is 12, then total charge is 24 microcoulomb, because the capacitance is in microfarad, so total charge is Q. Q is equal to 24 microcoulomb. Okay. Then, see, here total charge is Q, this charge is Q1, this charge is Q2, and this charge again is Q, this charge is Q. So, potential, if this capacitance is C3, let here potential difference is V2, let this point is C, this point is V, between C and V, potential difference is V2, between C, this potential difference is V1, this is V2, so this is C3. Between the plates of capacitor C3, potential difference is V2. Between these two plates, potential difference is V1. So here is potential difference V1, here is V1. Because 6 microfarad is sum of these two capacitors in parallel. Here V1 means total potential difference is V1. Now it is easier. Q1 is equal to C1 into V1. C1, C1 we got C1 2 microfarad. Then we have to find V1. First get V2. V is equal to Q by C. So Q, total charge is Q, capacitance is C3, total charge is 24, divided by capacitance C3 is 3, then V2 is equal to 8 volt. Okay. If this is 8 volt and total potential difference is 12 volt, then obviously V1, this is 8 volt, then V1 is equal to 12 minus 4 means 4 volt. So, C1 is equal to 2 microfarad, V1 is 4, so Q1 is equal to 8 microcoulomb. Okay. Similarly, Q2, C2, C2 into V1, potential difference is V1, C2, C2 is 4, V1 is 4, then it will come 16 microcoulomb. And finally, Q3, it is easier, Q3. Q3 is equal to capacitance is C3, potential difference is V2. Okay. So C3 is 3 microfarad, potential difference is 8, it will come 24 microcoulomb. See, total charge, total charge is 24 microcoulomb, this charge is also Q, 24 microcoulomb, and here this charge is divided into two parts, Q1 and Q2, 8 plus 16, again equals to 24 microcoulomb. Is it clear? Okay. The next question. Very easy question. Question number 5. Most easier question in this lecture. See, suppose this is a capacitor, capacitance C1. This is another capacitor, capacitance C2. Okay. And the circuit is completed like this. And here, there is a battery connected like this. Okay. Now it is assigned the value C1 is equal to 3 microfarad. Okay, C2 is also, let's take 3 microfarad, let's take for easier calculation, 3 microfarad, and this battery, potential difference is 12 volt positive, and this is at 0 potential, you may take like this, okay. So this is the given circuit, it is asked to find charge on capacitors C1 and C2. Find charges on capacitors of capacitances C1 and C2. See, we have to find charge on the capacitors. See, in very general way, the seat, otherwise we may apply potential method. This is positive. charge will come from this positive charge.
Conventional charge will be discussed in current electricity.
So this charge is divided into two branches. This charge is Q1, which appears on this capacitor. This charge is Q2, which will appear on this capacitor. So this is positive, this is also positive, this is at zero potential, this is at zero potential. So charge discharge will move to this capacitor, means this capacitor will be charged. But here we can't divide the charge. Suppose you may take this is Q and this is Q. Okay? Charge is divided. No, we can't divide because charge always seeks an easy path. Charge starts from conventional charge. Starts from positive and again enters at negative. This is conventional. So this is positive, this will be the charge, this is positive, this will be the charge, and this charge will enter at negative, this charge will enter at negative, as per our convention. This is purely convention. But actually, charge never flows through a capacitor. If a capacitor is connected between terminals of a cell and uncharged capacitor, the capacitor gets charged. After it is fully charged, there will be no flow of charge. Concept that is concept will be discussed on charging and discharging a capacitor, we'll discuss in brief. Okay. Then see, discharge is divided into two branches. This is Q1 and this is Q2. Obviously, these two capacitors, C1 and C2, are in parallel because charge is divided into two branches, Q1 and Q2. This is total applied voltage or potential difference V. Okay, V is 12 volt. Okay, then total capacitance in parallel grouping, these two are in parallel, now it is clear. Then total capacitance is C1 plus C2. C1 is 3, C2 is 3, then total capacitance is 6 microfarad and total charge is Q. Q is equal to equivalent capacitance into potential difference, 6 into 12, that's equals to 72. That's equals to 72 given in microfarad, so is it microcoulomb. 72 microcoulomb is total charge, and this charge is Q1, this charge is Q2, and Q1 is equal to C1 into V. This is V, this is V, in parallel potential difference M, C1. C1 is 3 microfarad, potential difference 12. So this is 36 microcoulomb. Obviously, if total charge is 72 and Q1 is 36, then Q2 is also 36 microcoulomb. 36 is equal to 72 microcoulomb. Okay, finding easier, very easier, not easier, very easier. Okay, then I am going to end this lecture, the last numerical. Okay, or we'll try to. Solve two, one or two numericals. See, let's see. Number six. These are easy numericals. You can catch very well. Just if I will show you the method, you can develop the method. These are too easy. Let's this question six is based on earthing. Of course, we have shown earthing in previous lectures. Sorry, in previous numericals. B point is earthed. Same. If it earthed, then potential becomes 0. So this is point A, this is a capacitor, this is a capacitor. Similar problem, similar numerical, and this point is earthed. So if this is point B, then potential of B is 0. Potential of B is 0. Let potential at A, applied potential is 20 volt. Potential at B is 0. So potential difference between A and B is 20 minus 0, 20 volt. This is the concept. Too easy. So, let this capacitance is C1, this is C2, this is C. Okay. Let C1 is 10 microfarad. C2 is 5 microfarad. And again, C3 is 5 microfarad. I have taken like this for easier calculation. Then, what is asked? Find potential difference between the plates of first capacitors. Potential difference between the plates of first capacitor. This is first capacitor, we have to find this potential difference V1. Of course, it may be asked to calculate potential difference across these two capacitors, so we can calculate. Okay. Then, what is potential difference between these two plates? Then let's find first equivalent capacitance. This is C1, 10 microfarad. These two, see, total charge is Q, discharge is Q, discharge is Q2, discharge is Q3. You may take discharge Q1, discharge Q1. Okay. So these two capacitors are in parallel, charge is divided. So total capacitance C2 and C3. Get RL, again 10 microfarad and connected to point B, this is point A. See, now these two capacitors, this is equivalent capacitance in parallel of these two capacitors. So now C1 and C parallel, CP are in series because charge is same. If this is Q1, now total charge is Q1. There is no division because two capacitors are combined to get a single capacitance. Okay. Now, equivalent capacitors, both are in parallel, then as per our formula, if n number of identical capacitors are connected in series, then equivalent capacitance is C by N, if each capacitance is C, okay, then it is equals to 10 into 10 divided by 10 plus 10, so 100 by 20 means 5 microfarad plus 10 by 2, 2 capacitors, 10 by 2, okay, you got it? Now, charge on it is Q1, then V1. V1 is equal to Q1 by C1. No, you have not got Q1. So total charge is Q1. Total charge is C equivalent into total potential difference. This is total charge Q1. Q1 is equal to equivalent capacitance 5. Total voltage is 20. So Q1 is equal to 100 micro. Q1 is equal to 100 microcoulomb, this is 100 microcoulomb. Capacitance is 10 microfarad, micro get cancelled, then it is equal to 10 volt. Is it clear? So of course, potential difference between these, between this combination is also, if this is 10, total is 20, then this is also 10. This is 10, this is 10. Okay. So, potential difference across these two plates is 10. Between these two plates is 10, these two plates is 10. So, total potential is 10, and here 10, sum of 10 and 10 is equal to 20. Is it clear? Last numerical. Very easy one. But it will look bigger, very easy. See, suppose this point is A. Okay, this is a capacitor of 40 microfarad. This is a capacitor of 60 microfarad. This is a capacitor of 60 microfarad. This is a capacitor of 60 microfarad. Okay, 60 microfarad, 60 microfarad, and 60 microfarad. Bring a combination, so you bring a branch from this point left. This capacitor is 10 microfarad, this capacitor is of 10 microfarad. Join, and this is B. This point is A, this point is B. Okay, find equivalent capacitance of the combination C. Total charge is Q. Here, total charge is Q, but here from Q. This is a path and this is a path. Okay? This is a path, this is a path. So these three, second plate of first capacitor connected to first plate of second capacitor, second plate of second capacitor connected to first plate of third capacitor. So these three capacitors are in series. Okay. Again, if this is a branch charge, then this charge is divided into two branches, or you may think. These are two first plates of two capacitors connected to a common point. These are two second plates connected to another common point, obviously these two are in parallel, then this point is A, this is 40 microfarad, and 60, 60, 60 in series, so total is 60 by 3, C by M in series means 20 microfarad, and this is also 10 and 10 in parallel, 20 microfarad, and finally connected to B. So these two, see, this is a common point, these two plates are connected to a common point, these two plates are connected to another common point, so finally this point is A, this capacitance is 40 microfarad, and these two are in parallel, two branches, so are divided, 20 and 20 in parallel, so total capacitance is 40 microfarad, and this is B. Now equivalent circuit between A and B, equivalent capacitance between A and B, both are in series, second plate is connected to first plate, then equivalent capacitance is 40 by 2 means 20 microfarad, okay, 20 microfarad. Suppose it is mentioned voltage applied between A and B, suppose it is mentioned voltage applied between A and B is 100 volt, then total charge is equivalent capacitance into total voltage, equivalent capacitance is 20 microfarad, voltage is 100, then total charge is 2000 microcoulomb. It may be asked like this. So, what we have discussed in today's lectures 22, part 1, numericals and combination of capacitors, these numericals are fundamental numericals. In next lecture, we will discuss some better numericals. Okay? So, thanks. Thanks, children. Thanks for your support. Thanks.